I'm Helen Phillips of Life on Phillips Lane. Welcome to my new home! So today is August 1st. This is our move-in day for this new home. We purchased it a little over a year ago, so it's been a long wait to get to move in, but here we are, and let's do an empty house tour. It's kind of a little chaotic, a little messy, but this is real life, and you get to see a sneak preview of the house. This is my, or what will be, my living room. We've got this beautiful double-sided gas fireplace, built-in TV, which I really like. Would love to do a frame TV one day, but you know, one thing at a time. And check out like this floor to ceiling tile. Isn't it beautiful? And if you check out behind you, you're going to see these huge windows. This house has so much light, which is one of the countless things that I love about it. Let's check out the kitchen next, which is huge. I kind of can't believe it. It's got this massive island. I have not one, but two ovens and two dishwashers, guys. Went from one oven, zero dishwashers, to two of each. I love the, again, natural light in here, the plantation shutters, which I've always dreamed of having. They're so beautiful. I love how classic and timeless they are. Got really nice views out my window. In the wintertime, you actually can see the Long Island Sound from here when the shrubbery isn't so nice and full and green. Kind of cool. Makes me a little more excited for New England winter, but not that much. Over here is where we'll put a kitchen table eventually, but for now it's kind of just empty because we don't have any furniture really, which you'll see as you get a real empty house tour. Next on to the dining room. This is a table that's kind of just because we don't really know where else to put it right now. Gives you an idea. Also, I wanted to put something underneath the chandelier so people don't hit their heads when they're walking by because that would be unfortunate. So if you pan around over here, you'll see this pocket door. We've got two of them that lead from like the dining room, living room area into the kitchen. And while it's not that totally open concept layout that most homes have, and a lot of the homes that I looked at had that, I really do love this. I think it's nice because then you don't have to look at the mess, and it still is definitely open enough for someone who is looking for that feeling. So yeah, that's what we got, and I love it. Let's check out down here now. This is the downstairs bathroom. It's a full bathroom, as you can see. A bit dark for my preference, but it's got so much room, which kind of makes up for that, and will definitely just, a new coat of paint will go such a long way. And down the road, I think at some point, I would love to redo the tile in here to something a bit more my taste. Across the hall, we've got one of the guest bedrooms. This house has a ton of bedrooms, which is really cool, because I am really excited to host all my friends and family when they come visit me in the new place. So this is one of the guest bedrooms. We put some furniture in it. This is where Emma's gonna be staying for her rest of the time with us this summer. So we're gonna miss having her. This is a random closet. I guess it's just like tech stuff in here, I don't know. I would love to count the number of closets in this house. I couldn't even take a guess with how many. This place has so much storage. Welcome now to our workout room. I already set up a couple mats so you guys can get the feel for it. But my vision here is I'd love to do a mixed fitness bike. I don't know if you guys have heard of them. Their headquarters are in Greenwich, Connecticut, so a local business close to my heart. And I love indoor cycling, so definitely want a mixed fitness bike in here. Going to put a bar along the wall here so I can do my bar classes, and definitely some full-length mirrors. We've just got this one for the meantime, which will do for now, but I definitely want like full-on bar studio vibes in here, plus the cycling bike, and there'll still be room for the yoga mats. Come on out and we'll check out the rest of the downstairs. In here is a bit of a mess right now, but that's okay. Just unloading a bunch of random boxes and some stuff. This, I think, is going to be one of the offices in the house. We don't really have a need for like a formal living room and family room. That's just not my style. So this will definitely be used as an office. I think if someone was moving in here, I think the people like who used to live here and had kids that were older, it was a great hangout space for them, but obviously don't need that. Ranger will just hang out with me. She doesn't need her own hangout spot. This is the mudroom, guys. I have a mudroom. This is crazy. It even has these cute built-in cubbies, which my vision would be doing a really fun bold wallpaper behind each cubby. I just think that would be like a fun little pop. And more closets here. This is out to the garage and the storage shed, but that's kind of boring, so we don't have to look at that. And now you're back to the dining room, so now we can head upstairs. Next stop on the second floor is our laundry room. And yeah, I've already got laundry to do, so I'm really making myself right at home on day one. As you should, right? This is my place. Kind of feels surreal, but here we are. This will be my Life on Phillips Lane studio. I'm so excited to have this creative space to create all the amazing content for you guys. It has a nice walk-in closet here, which I've already stuffed a bunch of clothes into. And you've got to check out these views though. Look at this. How lucky am I to have this view from my office? We'll go check it out more later, but for now, just a little sneak peek. Now let's come this way. Here's the hall bath. This lighting is amazing. I'm definitely going to be doing my makeup in this bathroom because it has the best lighting in the house thanks to this beautiful skylight. It's got really high ceilings, which is kind of cool. A lot of the rooms actually in this house have really high ceilings, but when I was doing my makeup today, I was pretty proud of how it turned out thanks to the natural light. Okay, we're gonna skip this room for now. I think it might be my favorite room in the house. It is so cool, and yeah, that's all I'm gonna say about it now. Let's come check out this next guest bedroom. This one, again, such high ceilings in here. Lots of natural light. My vision for this room is to do built-in bunk beds. I've had a Pinterest board of built-in bunk beds for years, and now to have a space to do it is really cool. So definitely going for like that coastal nautical theme. Needs new carpet, obviously paint job, but this room couldn't be more perfect. Next on to the master bedroom here. We have a really nice size space. One of the things about the condo that I loved was how large the master bedroom was. It was huge, way bigger than this room. And when I was doing the house hunting process, all the master bedrooms that we looked at, none of them compared. This was the closest, I think, in size, though, to the one in the condo. It's really spacious, really nice and light and bright, which I love. And I've got this great view of the pond, so it's really pretty. And now, the bathroom, it needs some love. But it's got a great layout, and if you can just envision a large soaking tub standalone underneath the window here. You've got a new shower. The toilet's kind of tucked away, which I like. And look at this vanity and how huge it is. It's a really long vanity. I think it's over 89 inches long, which is kind of crazy. So there's lots of space in here and I love it. Now to check out my favorite room in the house. You guys are gonna love this one. How cool. The room with the loft. It's got some fun constellation wallpaper, which wouldn't personally be my choice, but it's kind of growing on me, and I can imagine how difficult it is to take it off the ceiling, so I think we're gonna live with it for now. But definitely wanna take this wallpaper off in the foreseeable future. Just white paint everywhere. Definitely needs new carpet, but come on up. You've got to check out this loft. How fun is this? All of my friends and my sister, everyone really wants this room to be their room. Everyone's fighting over it, which I think is hilarious. And I don't blame them. How fun is this? It's like everyone can be a kid again. And for the grand finale, let's check out the backyard. Can you believe this is my backyard, guys? I still feel like this is a pinch me moment. I have this gorgeous pool, this huge deck. I don't know, you've got to do a spin around here to really capture the size of this deck. We haven't even checked out the screen and porch yet. I kind of forgot about that, to be honest, but there's a screen and porch. Also awesome. Definitely will be eating lots of meals al fresco this summer. I have pink hydrangea bushes galore, which if you guys know anything about me, know that I love hydrangeas. They're my favorite flower. And while I'm catching them at the end of the season this year, it is still okay. I see some fresh buds. We'll definitely be making some beautiful arrangements. Thank you so much for watching my empty house tour, guys, and I'm so excited that you'll be coming along on this journey with me for the next chapter of my life. I can't wait to do all the home projects, so make sure you stay tuned for that. Let me know what you think in the comments below.